The Ottawa of 1961 was a small government town and considered one of the safest cities in the world. In the Chancery Building of the Indian High Commission, located at 200 McLaren Street, Ottawa, a young officer by the name of Kuket Sankara Pillai had just finished his lunch and was preparing to draft a dispatch on Canada's approach to the ongoing Cuban crisis. He was surprised to see a visitor barge into the room, thinking that the person had come for some urgent work. KS, as his friends fondly called him, got up to greet the man. The man produced a rifle and shot KS point blank. Kuket Sankara Pillai was born in the village of Karyukulam in what is now the Alpazhua district of Kerala in the well-regarded Kuket family. Pillai was educated at the University College, Trivandrum, and after completing his master's, he began teaching there. Pillai was soon preparing for the prestigious Union Public Service exams that Independent India had just started to recruit civil servants to its most elite services, that is, IFS and the IAS. Pillai cleared the civil services examination, and after being interviewed by none other than the first Prime Minister of India, Jawaharlal Nehru, who made it a habit of interviewing all prospective IFS candidates, he was accepted into the newly constituted Indian Foreign Services in 1948, the first batch of the IFS. Pillai served in the Indian Embassy in Paris and Indian High Commission in Colombo, Sri Lanka, before taking up an assignment in the High Commission of India, Port of Spain, Trinidad and Tobago. He also served in the Ministry of External Affairs, New Delhi, before proceeding on assignment to Ottawa, Canada. Pillai's death came as a shock to everyone. His assailant, a Yugoslav immigrant by the name of Shani Farizi, had sought a visa to India, a request that had been rejected by a consular officer. Farizi, upset at the rejection, had come to the Chancery to shoot the consular officer, but had instead shot Pillai. The attacker walked out of the Chancery building without being challenged and later surrendered himself at a nearby police station. He was never tried, but was sent to a mental asylum for several years. Pillai's death shocked the nation. The then Prime Minister, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, expressed deep regret at the death of a distinguished younger member of the Foreign Service. Pandit Nehru had read out a report of the then High Commissioner of India in Ottawa in the Parliament. "We are all shocked at the tragic end of a brilliant officer. The shock will be terrible for his wife, who is expecting a baby." Pillai left behind two young children and a pregnant wife. While his village in his native Kerala mourned his death, he also became an inspiration for a new generation from the region who sought to emulate him and went on to join the Indian Foreign Service. Over the years, Pillai's death was reduced to a mere anecdote, with no fitting memorial to his sacrifice. The High Commission of India in Ottawa decided to commemorate Pillai's sacrifice as the first martyr from the Indian Foreign Service. The present High Commissioner of India to Canada, Ajay Bisaria, took the initiative to have the High Commission's consular waiting hall named after K.S. Pillai. A sapling has also been planted in his memory on the Chancery premises. Kuket Sankara Pillai fell in the prime of his life to the cruel bullets of an assassin. It was a terrible loss for his family, for the Indian Foreign Service, and for the Indian nation. His legacy and memory will live on and shall continue to inspire those who serve the nation in distant lands.